and when we look back over our life, isn't it a blessing just to say, ooh wee, ooh wee, another blessing. Thank you so much, choir. Thank you so much, Sister DeLoach. I sang that song before, but it didn't come out like that. Amen. Thank you all so much for blessing us with your gifts. Amen. Song. With your gift, oh God, of inspiration. Giving honor to God for it is in Him that we're able to move and breathe and have our being. Giving honor to Jesus the Christ who paid it all for you and for me on Calvary's cross. Giving honor to the Holy Spirit that's already here, moving from heart to heart and breast to breast. Giving honor, amen, to this great host of officers, amen, and the ministers, amen, that are associated with the preaching of the gospel and the teaching, amen, in our Zion. Giving honor to this great host of again, just officers and members of this great church. I want to take the opportunity to acknowledge, amen, the first lady of this great church who's in absentia today, Sister Rochelle Haywood, amen. Amen. Come on, let's give her a hand, amen. Miss Diamond, Miss Ebony, Miss Jane, and Mr. CJ, amen. We do thank God for you, amen. Giving honor, amen, to again, amen, Sister Carolyn Bradley, amen, Sister Bishop Majek, amen, Brother Michael DeLoach, amen, Sister Latonya DeLoach, amen, here with us. We give honor, amen, to Sister Ola DeLoach, amen, and Sister Eula Everett. It's so good, amen, to amen. Come on, amen. 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 So good to have you all here with us this morning. Amen. Dr. Sam Purnell, who's here with us this morning. Amen. Sister Virginia, a name so nice that they start naming states after you. Amen. Sister Virginia, we thank God that you're here with us this morning. And we thank God, amen, for Brother Willie Purnell, who's here with us this morning. Amen. Standing at the post. Amen. Amen. We thank God, amen, this morning for Sister Dorothy Walden. We thank God this morning for Sister Lula Long and Sister Hattie DeLoach. We're so delightful, delighted that you're here with us this morning. Sister Lois Boone, we thank God that Sunshine is here with us this morning. We certainly thank God, amen, for you. We thank God for Brother Hewitt. We thank God for Brother Purnell. We're here with us, amen, this morning, amen. Acknowledging again this great host of musical and inspirational power, amen, that blessed us this morning. We thank God for this great choir, these great musicians, great singers and directors, the great men and women of God, all that have assembled at this great and holy place this morning. Turn, if you will, quickly. Look at your neighbor and say, Pastor, say, quickly. To 1 Corinthians chapter 6. And didn't Sister Ola do a wonderful job with that this morning?
Yes, sir.
Amen. She read it, amen, and then went straight through the doxology. Then blessed us with a summary, amen. I'm sure she's gonna say something to me later on. Amen. Just where get it out of the way, amen. Amen. And so once you have that, if you would stand, I just want to read that as confirmation in our hearing this morning, and then we'll take our text, amen, and then our topic, and then we ask the Lord to bless us to preach and teach the word, amen. If you're there, simply say amen.
Amen.
If you're on the way, say I'm on the way. Chapter 6, verse 12 through verse 20, we read these words. All things are lawful unto me, but all things are not expedient. All things are lawful for me, but I will not be brought under the power of any. Meats for the belly, and the belly for meats, but God shall destroy both it and them. Now, the body is not for fornication. Look at your neighbor and say, the body is not for fornication.
It's not for fornication.
But for the Lord. And the Lord is for the body. Verse 14 says, and God hath both raised up the Lord and will also raise up us by his own power. Verse 15 says, know ye not that your bodies are the members of Christ? Shall I then take the members of Christ and make them the members of an harlot? God forbid. What? Know ye not that he which is joined to an harlot is one body? For two, saith he, shall be one flesh. But he that is joined unto the Lord is one spirit. But you may say, he that is joined unto the Lord, is one spirit. So verse 18 says, flee fornication. Every sin that a man doeth is without the body, but he that committed fornication sinneth against his own body. What, know ye not that your body is the temple of the Holy Ghost, which is in you, which ye have of God, and ye are not your own? Look at your neighbor and say, ye are not your own.
Ye are not your own.
Verse 20, which is our key verse, says, for ye are bought with a price. Therefore glorify God in your body and in your spirit, which are God's. You may be seated. Those that would need a topic for just a little while today, I want to share with you, to preach and teach from the topic, scratched and dented. Scratched and dented. Look at your neighbor and say, scratched.
Scratched
and dented. Let us pause for a moment as we go to the Lord in prayer. Lord, help me preach, help me teach, have thine own way today. Dear Lord, bless us in a special way. Don't let us leave the same way that we came, but let us be better for you, Lord, in Jesus' name. Now, Lord, allow the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart to be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Have your way. In Christ's name we pray. Amen. Look at your neighbor and say, scratched and dented. When you look at this particular message, at this particular pericope of scripture or unit of scripture, it's allowing us to understand that we need to stay away from sexual sins. In fact, when you read this in the New Revised Standard Version, it says, someone may say, I'm allowed to do anything, but not everything is helpful. I'm allowed to do anything, but I won't allow anything to control or gain control over my life. Food is for the stomach, and the stomach is for food, but God will put an end to both of them. However, the body is not for sexual sin, but for the Lord, and the Lord is for the body. God raised the Lord, and by his power, God will raise us. Don't you realize that your bodies are parts of Christ's body? Should I take the parts of Christ's body and make them parts of a prostitute's body? That's unthinkable. Do you realize that the person who unites himself or herself with a prostitute becomes one body with that individual? So God says the two will be one. However, the person who unites themselves with the Lord becomes one with him. So stay away from sexual sins. Other sins that people commit don't affect their bodies the same way sexual sins do. And so people who sin sexually sin against their own body. Don't you know that your body is a temple that belongs to the Holy Spirit? The Holy Spirit, whom you receive from God, lives in you. You do not belong to yourselves. You are bought with a price. So bring glory to God in the way you use your body. Look at your neighbor. Tell him, I thank God for my body. Our topic is scratched and dented. And when we look at the terms scratched and dented, there are some interrogatives that are associated with our key text to help us to understand that we're all bought with a price, and so we need to glorify God with the way we use this body. Just this morning, Sister Carol Bradley was talking about the importance of watching what we say. Come on, somebody. Sometimes folks say stuff to us that don't have a relationship like we do with Christ, but we have to be careful to bring everything under subjection, because if we don't, this mouth can get us in trouble. Come on, somebody. So we need to understand that we're bought with a price so that we bring glory to God in the way that we walk, in the way that we talk, in the way that we share, amen, with one another. The interrogatives associated with our key verse or this key text, verse 20, it allows us to realize that when we break down the interrogatives with the text, first we must begin with the who. The who of the text is you and I who were born into sin and could not afford to pay our own ransom. But how many of us know that the Lord made a way? The what is that we found ourselves born in sin due to Adam and our ancestral lineage. The when is since the beginning of our lives. The why is because Adam and Eve sinned or their rebellion against God. The where is in Eden or the Garden of Eden is where this act takes place. And the question of how, the wages of sin is death. How many of us know that the gift of God is eternal life? The answer to the how is wrapped up in John 3 and 16. Because God so loved the world that he gave us his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him would not perish, but have everlasting life. Well, that leads us to the cultural hermeneutic of the text. When we look at this text and we break down the cultural hermeneutic, we must realize that our ancestral lineage has been stretched and dented since the time we arrived in America. We've been stretched and dented on slave ships and in the transatlantic trade system, we were stretched and dented. If we just explore it and dig a little deeper, we'll realize that we were stretched and dented on the Mayflower. We were stretched and dented on Plymouth Rock. We've been stretched and dented due to slavery and oppression, and we were stretched and dented due to being counted only as 3/5 of a human being. We were stretched and dented due to the oppression and depression that has impacted us since the beginning of time. We were stretched and dented due to the loss of our leaders like Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King and Malcolm X and many others that have gone before us. We've been stretched and dented due to having to deal with Jim Crow and racial injustice right here in our towns and cities, and it is still evident in our society today. We've been stretched and dented due to the fact that it was 2008 before we ever had a president that looked like us, talked like us, and reflected our ideology. In the United States of America, right here, we've been stretched and dented due to the impact of disease, of HIV, AIDS, cancer, high blood pressure, diabetes, and heart disease. We've been stretched and dented due to the fact that in the United States, we still have to deal with injustice, unfair acts, and unemployment practices, and prejudices. Even in the year of 2016, where our young men can be gunned down and be shown on YouTube, and justice still wait dormant, we've been stretched and dented. We've been stretched and dented due to the fact that many of our men are not stepping up to support the institution of the family, and many of our black women are allowing themselves to be subjected to relationships where they're beaten and abused, and now we wait not on the word from God, but we wait on what the NFL is doing and what the NBA is doing, and we've been stretched and dented because we live in a society where the church says, come as you are, but the club says there is a dress code. We've been stretched and dented. We've been stretched and dented due to an array of reasons, but God has a way. And as we transition to the exegesis of this text, I want you to know that whether you want to admit it or not, even right here, many of us in the church have been stretched and dented. I remember not long ago there was a faucet that I kept turning and it just wouldn't work. And what was happening in this illustration is I was turning the faucet the wrong way, expecting the water to run out. And finally, to my surprise, when I turned the faucet the opposite direction, water began to flow. And though many of us are doing the wrong thing, we keep expecting to get different and better results, but it's not until we change the direction then, and only then, can we expect to get better results. And so the first principle that I want to share with you here today is we understand what it means to be stretched and dented is that we've got to get connected. Look at your neighbor and say, we've got to get connected. In Hebrews chapter 1, verse 1 through 3, it says, God having of old time spoken to the fathers and the prophets by divers voices and divers manners, hath at the end of these days spoken unto us by his Son, whom he appointed heir of all things, through whom he also made the worlds, who being the effulgence of his glory and his very image of his substance, and upholding all things by the word of his power, we being made purification of sin, sat down at the right hand of the majesty on high. I want you to know today that you'll find in John 15:5 that Jesus says, I am the vine and ye are the branches. He that abideth in me and I in him, the same beareth much fruit, for apart from me you can do nothing. I want you to know today that Jesus is our source. Yeah, the job is good, but the job is only the resource. Jesus is the primary source that wakes us up in the morning, that starts us on our way, that allows us to be able to walk with him and talk with him. We've got to come into a covenant relationship with Jesus. You can't be in a relationship with Jesus and rob him in tithes and offering. You all know who he is. His name is Jesus. He's the lily of the valley. He's the bright and morning star. He's the balm in Gilead. And once the appliance connects to the source of power, then it begins to run. I want you to know today that I took liberty to look up that term scratch. And scratch means to break or to tear. Dented is a transitive verb, and it means to have a weakening effect. But the intransitive verb means to sink inward. On the Bible list of those that are scratched and dented is one that we know that had an issue. She was a woman that had an issue of blood. She had been scratched and dented. Had wasted away most of her, all of her wealth and all that she had gained, but she had a problem and she had a flow of blood and in all of her life she had been trying to get healed, had been trying to come into the presence of someone that would be able to tell her that there's hope. And it did not happen until she met Jesus, and then all of a sudden she was healed. But before that time she had been scratched and dented. There were three boys that were in a fiery furnace, these three Hebrew boys, and when they were there, they were scratched and they were dented because of their faith and their belief in God. How many of us know that Jesus appeared right there in the midst of the furnace with them when they were scratched and they were dented and they were blessed and they were able to come out of the fire unharmed? There was also a man that was sitting by the pool of Bethesda for 38 long years. And for that period of time, he had been scratched, he had been stepped over, and his personality had been dented until he had an experience with Jesus. And Jesus said, take up thy bed and walk. Many of us, just like these individuals, have been scratched and dented. Somebody has told you that you can't accomplish the dreams that God has set for you in your life. Somebody has told you that you'll never be anything and you'll never amount to nothing. You've been scratched and dented because of